Michael right, Majors, like, of course, gets to play first because he's a higher seed.
Mm-hmm. All right, we're going to have our tour switch that. We have changed the rules for feature match area where you've got to have your lands, creatures, graveyard, and library kind of all in a standardized position. A mountain to start things off for Michael Majors.
And, yeah, it's no surprise that the 27 land deck wants to fetch end of turn to not draw more lands.
Here's another key card for Mike. It's Jace, Friend's Prodigy, another card that we've seen in multiple different decks, a real player in Standard.
So you can't have lands in front, but I guess you can have lands on the side? Is that...
You put it next to the creature.
Elvish Mystic running into Jace. Jace is an 0-2. He's not afraid.
Sick blocks by Mike Majors, and here we go.
Not the first opponent, but I guess the last, you know, technically.
Yes.
That it has to read Sphinx's Tutelage.
That's right. You guys can take a look at what Tutelage does there.
And that's not a Banishing Light. That's an Eidolon, which now we've got lands in front, on the side, and in back.
All right, so Eidolon of Blossoms is, you know, it's interesting. That's not necessarily what Majors wants to see, but it does kind of help him along.
No, I think he's happy with that. Look, he gets to mill.
And that's those two share the same. You see his face. So remember, if the cards share a color with each other, you repeat the process. So just on that one, he milled four cards.
And then two more from his draw step. And now, you know, Majors has another Tutelage in hand. He could just play another Tutelage. Didn't see a Banishing Light last turn. This game could be over very quickly.
This could be turbo mill.
Yeah.
Here's another Tutelage, and remember, he's still got the Jace activation, which, of course, looting says draw a card, so it is going to trigger both of the Tutelage, and this one could be over very quickly. Was that another Banishing
Light? It is another Banishing Light, so it's not going to be over quite that quickly. Banishing Light's at least going to take down one of the Tutelages.
It looks like Arturo wants to...
He's going for Starfield and X. He wants to race. Starfield's presumably going to be active next turn. He didn't draw off Eidolon. And
he forgot to draw a card, or he didn't.
Presumably
want to.
Forgot to.
Yeah, I think you still would draw a card there. I mean, it actually is, interestingly, some type of a decision against the mill deck, whether you want to help him along.
You don't actually have an option, so presumably.
Oh, it's not a me.
Yeah, it's not a strategic choice that Artur can make.
Right, okay. Yeah, we'll try to let him know down there, but I don't think he did draw it.
Mike Major gets to mill for four in turn of Jace, four on draw step. It looks like a Tormenting Voice to kick things off,
yeah.
Which is another four. And this is without hitting doubles, which the Tutelages can very easily.
Absolutely. Artur's deck is pretty evenly spread on colors, or is it?
It's mostly black-green.
Mostly black-green, okay. All right, there's that Tormenting Voice. And there's cards disappearing here, though we can't actually see them.
Yeah, we're going to need to see these mills one by one.
Yeah.
Just because it's so much fun.
We need the value, yeah. All right,
so it's not some doubles.
Double activations, but doesn't.
But at the very least, Jace can flip and flashback Tormenting Voice.
He's even got the mana to do that right now. Here's two more activations. He bricked. But still, these are huge chunks of Artur's library going away. Now, of course, it's just like life total. It doesn't matter until they're all gone, which is why Artur's decided he's going to just try to take the aggressive route and punish the fact that these Tutelages don't affect the board. And while they do get the mill going, you know, it only matters if he actually gets milled out. You know, if he's got one card in his library, it was all for naught. So I like what Artur's doing here. But these are adding up very quickly for Majors.
And I think Majors wants Artur to keep drawing cards off Eidolon. So if Majors notices that he did not, he definitely wants to ensure that he does.
I think you're right.
So Majors deciding whether he wants to use Jace. He could get back Tormenting Voice. But then the Jace would die to the Eidolon. But Jace is likely to die next turn anyway, because Eidolon is going to be a 4-4. Starfield's going to trigger getting back a Banishing Light. Artur's actually going to cast another one. Majors does not know that. The funny thing is, Artur actually had a pretty good draw here. Turn three, yeah. Eidolon, turn four, Starfield next. I imagine that's one of the things he wants to start with.
Totally. gain a couple of life here from a Radiant Fountain for Mike Majors.
He's going to cast a Treasure Cruise.
He's cruising now? Jeez.
So presumably he's not using Jace as a to flash anything back then. So he draws three. Each tutelage triggers three times. So still there.
You.
Oh, double trigger.
So that was one trigger.
Yep. Two triggers. Three triggers, and then one trigger, double. Two triggers, double. And three triggers.
Uh-oh.
And, nope, they're all gone.
And that was it. He had nothing.
He milled
left.
Them out on turn five.
My God.
Turn two Jace. Turn indeed. Three tutelage. Turn four tutelage. Turn five mill you out.
This is such an easy game. Why have I been attacking people my whole life? Mike Majors picks up game one in impressive fashion. Like you said, it looked like a really good draw for Artur, but was not up to snuff. Double sinks his tutelage. Gets the job done. Wow.
Okay. Yeah, that was insane.
This thing could be over very quickly.
Both
take a look at Artur kind of hunched over, like, what the heck am I supposed to do here?
And Michael Majors gets to side in a bunch of negates and annuls.
Wow.
And those seem like real cards. So if you're Artur,
yeah, what are you looking at here? Does he have anything?
More
out Thought Seize.
His Thought Seize is clearly good.
Yes.
Infinite Obliteration doesn't seem quite as good.
No. Just taking Jace away, and a turn too late.
In Offenza, at least can attack, I suppose.
I think I would put in three on Offenza here.
Yeah.
I mean, it depends on what he can take.
Well,
out,
Doom Mike
right?
Giant's pretty poor.
Yes, I would take that one out.
What else isn't great? Farika, God of Affliction, doesn't also seem like exactly what you want.
Is Krufix's Insight something you can keep in your deck?
It's not really a grindy matchup.
Mills you for six?
Yeah.
I think I would take that out.
Yeah, I could definitely see you doing that. Whereas, Michael Major's not really as interested, and I think like Whelming Wave and Send to Sleep sound a little less good. The Whelming Wave against Starfield Onyx is kind of interesting. Mm. Turns all enchantments into creatures, then you just get to...
Oh, and then they all go away?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm not, yeah, I'm a little underwhelmed by that card in this matchup. Since
a little underwhelmed by it?
Well, I'm certainly not overwhelmed. In fact, maybe I'm just whelmed. Disperse is kind of interesting just because it does free a Banishing Light here.
Yeah, and you know, we have seen Major set up turns where he really only needs a Sphinx's Tutelage in play for one turn cycle to put a huge dent down. So it's something like Disperse, End Step, get back a tutelage, and then, you know, kind of go off could definitely be a thing.
And it looks like the players are kind of shuffling up and ready here. Artur is trying to think, like, what is going on here exactly?
Yeah.
Like, what am I supposed to do?
He made it all the way to the finals. Gets turn five milled out. And now he's trying to scramble to come up with a better draw than the one he presented there. Majors doesn't look super concerned here. He's pretty stoic when he plays.
Yeah, this is a good start to a season for sure. Michael Majors was gold last year, but not currently gold, though. Starting off with a GP win, or at the very least a finals, definitely gets you on your way.
Absolutely.
Make sure you're qualified for next Pro Tour. In fact, all the players in the top eight are now qualified for Pro Tour Milwaukee.
For Milwaukee.
Our producer Andy points out it is fitting that Michael Majors will qualify for Pro Tour Milwaukee off of this. So you can't even blame me for that one.
Goodness sakes. Yeah, Mike, you know, with this beginning to his season, he's definitely going to be a player to watch. I've already seen him, you know, he's tested with some teams when he's on the PT. He plays a lot online. Well, that got about the best reviews possible.
So maybe, yeah, I don't understand. Someone else comes up with, in my opinion, a very mediocre joke. and it gets incredibly good reviews, whereas my fantastic ones get universally panned. So when Michael Majors thinks for so long for before his turn one play, that signifies
that
magmatic insight to me, but it could also just be he's got a sequence of tap lands and is not sure what to play. So that's interesting. He just played Mountain Go, so did not have a tap land.
And did not want to play magmatic insight. Maybe has one.
Yeah. Oh, well, we're about to. Oh, no, I was going to say we're about to find out with Brain Maggot, but no, that's a Herald of the Pantheon. Ah. Oh, and Fire Impulse, which, you know, that kills Brain Maggot, Eidolon, and Herald of the Pantheon.
Yeah.
So. You know, that's what Michael Majors was thinking about. He had a one red spell. It just happened to be Fiery Impulse, and now he gets to curve into a Jace.
Wow.
So this is a pretty good start for him.
This is great. Are we going to see a Brain Maggot? What are we going to see here? You know, this is where the less potent plays from Artur's deck just look so weak.
And Artur does not have white mana. He's not able to kill Jace with the mana he has available. And if Michael Majors has a way to flip... Okay, he's a brain maggot. But if he has a spell, he could potentially flip Jace this turn. It's a hand of tutelage, insight, and land. So, unsurprisingly, tutelage goes down.
All right, well... Majors is going to be able to use that insight to help him find...
Well, see, what Michael Majors can do here...
Can he actually flip Jace this turn?
Yeah, he can insight, flip Jace. He could even Fiery Impulse the Brain Maggot if he found another red. He'd have to find an untapped red source, but that is a pretty efficient start. Though, it's kind of funny. You kind of don't want to kill Brain Maggot until you have a turn in order to cast the tutelage right away. Because right now it's protected from Thoughtseize. It's safely hiding under the Brain Maggot.
It is, yeah. And a lot of, I think, the game plan for Majors will end up revolving around Anger of the Gods, which is going to sweep away that Brain Maggot anyway. He doesn't have any right now. But, you know, a couple of extra threats or another Brain Maggot or something from Artur, and all of a sudden Anger of the Gods gets rid of it. Huh.
And also, this protects Jace from Banishing Light. Because if it gets targeted by Banishing Light, you can exile it and bring it back. Artur's right. hand has Doomwake Giant, Llanowar Wastes, and no white mana, no Eidolon, so not much to play.
Not a lot of action, and it looks like Majors decided he does not want to flip Jace. He did not activate it. He's just leaving it in creature mode here.
Again, presumably to protect it. Did he draw another tutelage?
Unclear.
Looks
yes,
like it.
He did. He's going to gain a life off of Swiftwater Cliffs and just pass the turn back. Like you said, not using the Jace and just keeping it up. Is there a removal spell he's playing around here specifically?
I think Banishing Light, because it's a sorcery speed removal spell. He knows that Artur has access to Hero's Downfall, but Artur might not board it in. Maybe he has enough dead cards that he would board in Hero's Downfall. But for right now, Majors is happy just kind of chilling where he is.
Can't blame him.
Players in the Super Sunday Series event.
Infinite Obliteration did come in.
Oh, wow.
Take that, Jace.
The problem, of course, being that Jace is already on the battlefield. Look at Majors.
He's like, what is this doing?
He's like, fair enough. It's unlikely that Majors has another Jace in his hand. He says, sure. Shows him the hand, which is... Is that land, land, land? Meanwhile, Artur is going to get a look at the entire library of Majors and get an idea of how he sideboarded. That's why he's going through each and every card.
Yeah, that's not... I mean, that is information, but it looks like Michael Majors actually took out a Jace even.
So he kind of got him.
Well, yeah.
I mean, this... didn't really affect much here.
No, it's not particularly effective even if Michael Majors had Jace. The problem is, if he has Jace, he's going to cast it. And if he doesn't have Jace, then what does Infinite Obliteration do for you?
Right. Yeah, we talked about this during the sideboarding. It's a turn too slow as well. Jace can just come down naturally the turn before you can cast it.
All right, so Artur then has no other plays. I have to assume Jace is going to flip now, right? Because now you get to flip Jace end of turn. I guess it doesn't matter whether you flip in a turn. You might as well draw for your turn because you're not getting double taps anyway. But this is the turn where you would want to to get back the tutelage from the Brain Maggot by flashing back Fiery Impulse, just playing a second tutelage, and then just you have a pretty good clock. I don't know what Michael Major's hand is exactly, but he's got a lot of good options here. I don't think there's any way this turn ends poorly for him. He even doubled up on that tutelage trigger there. So Jace flips. Starts out at 5. May go to 2 to Impulse to kill tutelage. Could also just see something like Flashback Magma, like not even care about the other second tutelage that's hiding under the Brain Maggot and just cast like Magmatic Insight, cast Tormenting Voice, maybe followed up with a Treasure Cruise.
I mean, we saw what happens if 2 tutelage get going on.
All right, looks like Fiery Impulse?
Yeah.
No, it looks like the Insight.
He is just going for the Insight plane. So he's just going to ignore the Brain Maggot.
The reason to do this would be that if Michael Majors has triggers. A bunch of card draw in his hand, then he might be able to just cast, he'd rather just be happy casting a bunch this turn and not worrying about getting a second tutelage in play.
Okay.
Or maybe he already has a second tutelage to play. No, he's got Monastery Siege.
Monastery Siege, okay.
Choosing cons to the draw an extra card mode.
Right, and that is drawing an extra card. It
does trigger the tutelage. We've been seeing Majors run this all day. Now, here's a white source. It's coming to play tap, though. That I don't know if these turn delays are really going to work out in Archer's favor.
I mean, this is his 6th land, and he finally has hit white. Michael Majors has kind of had the green light here to do what he wants to do.
And then Jace gets hit down to 1.
Which I'm assuming isn't a huge deal.
Doomwake Giant gets cast, but it's not a particularly effective threat. So now Majors draws 2 on his draw step, discards a card to Siege.
So that's 2 triggers on the tutelage. Yikes. This one could be over quickly again. Artur just doesn't seem to have enough punch. Remember, Michael is at 22.
Oh, yeah. This race is not even against Michael's life total. First, it's against Artur being able to stop Michael from just casting a million Sphinx's tutelages.
Right. Michael has cards in hand here. He's trying to decide, figure out what he wants to do for the turn, but he's already got a nice engine set up just straight up. He does need to make sure to keep the creatures at bay at some point, but he could try to end the game a lot quicker here. And there's a Treasure Cruise. Here we go. All aboard.
3 tutelage triggers.
3 triggers.
1, 2, and...
Does he get a repeater?
He does.
He does.
See, look, infinite obliteration costing Artur some more.
So that was 8 cards in the library there. Yeah, this is just adding up quite quickly. Especially given that right now, Artur just doesn't have a reasonable clock on Majors.
No, Artur's best case scenario is that he survives this turn, untaps, and gets to cast Banishing Light on the tutelage that's in play. But given, you know, that Michael Majors has just drawn at least, you know, he drew 7 cards this turn. One on his draw step, 1 off the Siege, 3 off the Cruise, 2 off the Tormenting Voice. Of course he's going to find more card draw. Of course he's going to find like a negate or another tutelage or something.
Exactly. I mean, he did have to discard some of those cards, but he's going to basically filter to the good stuff. There's another one. And he passes a turn back.
No flipping cards off the top of your deck. It's been a very long day. Let's make this round go very quickly. Welcome to round 9. You have 50 minutes. Please begin.
I think they're figuring out if his life total is correct here just as he's passed the turn back.
Maybe a dispute over whether Radiant Fountain gained.
We have him at 22 life. It could also be if he had already played a land this turn, I suppose. Could be the question here.
Yeah. But they both have 6 here, and I don't think either has missed a land drop. Artur's on the play. This looks legit to me. Oh.
Okay. Well, it looks like it passed the test here. He played that island and then passed the turn back.
Here comes a Banishing Light, which may even get hit by a Negate. I would not be surprised if that were the case. Yep.
Snapped
it off with
even
better.
Yeah.
I guess it's about the same in this case, but Anul, yeah, quite effective in this matchup.
Yep. Okay, and finally, Jace will die here as the
Doomwake Giant.
The Doomwake Giant still has enough power to actually kill it, even though it was minus two from Jace. And there's not exactly the dream follow-up here. But he did manage to take Jace offline. The problem, of course, being that the Sphinx's tutelage is there. And here we go, the obligatory library check. Guess in the mid-20s, mid to low 20s, something like that.
Looks like 20. 22 even.
Okay. 22 cards left.
Minus four from just the draw steps.
Minus four from minimum from the draw steps.
Yeah. And no doubles.
Bringing Michael Majors ever closer
18
to
cards
a GP
away from,
title.
From winning this Grand Prix.
Yeah, the cards are just flowing into the graveyard at this point, and a few draw cards, and Michael Majors could put this thing away.
Discard a card to the Siege. Looks like kicking things off with a Tormenting Voice.
Mm-hmm. Still going. Maybe another
second
tutelage.
Oh, Anger, which turns into a second tutelage because it gets Brain Maggot.
Indeed. Though, will Majors actually be able to play a card here?
He might just go tutelage. Oh, he's going to roast the Doomwake just to make sure that he doesn't end up dying.
So Anger plus Roast takes out the Doomwake. Majors is a patient player. He knows that.
Yeah, Doomwake being exiled because Anger was cast.
Yes. And this is, of course, the obligatory trigger here. And I don't think Majors is going to be too sad about this one either. Though he did think about it there, signaling he may have an Annul.
And then a Thought Seize, which...
Let's find out.
Treasure Cruise.
Wow, Treasure Cruise.
So do you take
the
Treasure Cruise or the Tutelage? You almost have to just take the Treasure Cruise, even though the second Tutelage is also just going to end the game.
Yeah, this is not a good scenario here for Artur. Wow. He's going to take the Cruise.
I think you have to.
I think you do, too.
Michael Majors just has a Null in hand, so he's not even worried about anything here.
No.
Because Banishing Light is the one card he can get.
Yeah, he has the board state to beat him as it sits. He's going to add to that and increase the clock anyway.
Got a double trigger there. Off.
Yes, he did.
Looks like 9 cards left.
Was it 9? Okay.
Another Sphinx's Tutelage.
There's a Tutelage, and remember, he still has the Monastery Siege. It looks like we're going to see Blue-Red Mill take this thing down. He's just a turn away. And that's going to do it! Michael Majors wins the GP with Blue-Red Mill. As Andrew Cuneo, gives the old fist pump wherever he's watching. Congratulations to Michael. Artur, a fantastic finish for him as well. Everybody's smiling down there. Judges. It was crazy. I can't believe that Mill won this GP.
Yeah, that is insane. we see Michael Majors go 7-0, 8-0, 9-0. It's like, all right, he finished the day at 9-0, and it's like, well, that's pretty cool.
He must have had good matchups, and right? that's what we justified.
And then a couple runs later, he's 12-0.
He's just 12-0.
And it's just like, well, I think he's going to make top 8. He does drop around, and then he ends up winning his last round, or second to last round, scooping his last round, making it to the top 8, and just kind of running through the top 8.
Yeah, and just ran right through it. Did not look particularly rough for him either. It wasn't like one of those... scenarios where he just squeaked out the last card right before he was about to die. It was like pretty convincing.
No, that game wasn't close.
That game wasn't close, and the first one was even more in his favor.
Right. He won the game on turn 5 in game 1.
Yes.
That's insane.
Milled him out on turn 5.
It's not, it wasn't like, oh, yeah, like Paul said, it's not a slow millstone deck. This is turbo mill. Like, he just won the game instantly.
Yeah, when that thing turns the corner, it drops the hammer, and we saw the library just fade away into the graveyard. And we have our champion, Michael Majors. We're actually going to get a word with Michael, too. We're going to get him over here, and I'll have a chat with him before we sign off for the tournament. But, what stands out for you, Luis? We're winding down what was a good long weekend here in San Diego.
Standard's pretty diverse. There's a lot of stuff going on. We saw Jeskai. We saw this Blue-Red Mill deck, Obzon Constellation, Normal Obzon, Green-White Aggro. Like, we saw a pretty wide swath of decks. One thing that I thought was interesting was that Mono Red did not perform very well this weekend.
No. It did put a decent amount of players into day 2, but that also could be a reflection of that quite a few players played it in day 1 as well, and it did not do well in day 2. So, Yeah. I don't know. Maybe it was a short-lived deck for the Pro Tour and maybe this tournament, and that was about it.
No, I don't think that's true.
Because it seems legit.
Yeah, I think the mono-red deck is quite good. I think the prevalence of green-white may have impacted it. But you're going to see these things, you know, go back and forth. Like, I think mono-red does not mind playing as mill, for example. I don't think if you want to play this mill deck in a field full of mono-red.
Yeah, so it'll be. I think that we'll see Mono Red make its comeback again.
Yeah, yeah.
We just heard the announcement over the loudspeakers from our head judge, Lems, as he's known, Jason LeMahieu, and he even said what deck Michael was playing. They don't normally do that, but everybody loves these type of decks.
Well, it's kind of insane. Like, how likely it is that this deck is good? It's a shame Kuno didn't actually come and play the deck here. But
I'm sure he's thinking that right now, too.
Yeah, yeah.
But he's got to be proud that his creation made it all the way to the finals and, in fact, won the GP here in San Diego.